Have you ever wondered if advertising with the Inferno would work? It just did. For more information, visit us at www.fredoniaradio.com.
Do you think that Kurt Cobain was a really cool guy? Do you still wear old plaid shirts?
Yeah, who is better?
Say all of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let go. Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Great, the opportunities as Coach Digby would say, but definitely Zawadzki did have some interesting saves there. He always makes it interesting anyway. He's a very flashy player, and Bogart, that did look pretty good as well from what I was able to listen to from Anthony and Jordan. So guys, of course, the Lakers cannot be happy with their performance in the first period. The Lakers expect to be winning after the first 20 minutes. The coaching staff is very hard on their players. So what's going to be the biggest adjustment the Lakers are going to have to make if they're going to come out in the second period and be more successful on the offensive side?
Well, in the first period, the end of the first period, they were heavy on the forecheck. They were following up the shots, and you heard the same names, Botten, Ragusao. They were cycling the puck Neal at the beginning of the power play as well. But these guys just need to keep the puck in the offensive zone and tighten down defensively. I mean, everybody's back-checking. They're doing a good job, but they're not getting the right offensive chances that they want. They need those smart opportunities, the smart shots, and looking for that perfect shot.
They've also got to hit that. How many times do we hear Dole say, just wide or over the net? Too many times they miss the net. They got to start hitting the net with their shots. Luckily for them, they start the second period on a power play. So we know what that means, a lot of one-timers, a lot of passing, but they got to get shots to the net.
And, Mike, I think you make an amazing point. If you look at the live stats here, Sean Holshoff wide, McElhotty wide, Rutkowski block, Joey Davies wide. You know, if they start getting these pucks through and getting them on net, good things are going to happen. And, you know, a 14-shot period sounds a little bit different than a 10-shot period, and it's really making a difference. And Mike Cicero, as you said in the pregame, puck possession is extremely important. And we saw it in the waning periods of the waning minutes of the first period. Oswego had very good puck possession, and it led to a penalty, and now they are on the power play once again. So, you know, for the first time. So it should be an interesting complexion and to the rest of this game, and puck possession is definitely going to play a huge role.
Well, this is going to be interesting. We did see this earlier in the season. The Lakers committing some penalties. One of the guys we talked about in the pregame, countdown to faceoff, who was one of the biggest culprits, that was Charlie Pelnyk. He's not even playing today, so you can't point the finger at Pelnyk. Only a few penalties, though. The Lakers have plenty of time. And if you don't get a penalty for the rest of the game, you'll look back and say, great day on the special teams for the Lakers. So they have plenty of time to turn around. That's not an issue. But scoring for the Lakers, I don't know about you guys. I feel like at some point the bubble is going to have to burst. You can't be expecting to score 8 goals a game or average as many goals as the Lakers are. They're going to have to be more familiar with playing close games. So do you think playing a close game like this could hurt or help a team? Because I think personally, when it comes down to March, you want to have some close game experience. What do you guys think about that?
Well, Sam, you know, it's not like, you know, the freshmen coming into this year, this is their first time ever playing hockey. They've been in close games. They must have played in juniors or high school, some sort of higher level hockey. So I'm not too worried about them having close game experience. I'm sure at some point in their hockey careers, this is not their first stop. I don't know if it's their last stop. But, you know, and when we talk about the special teams, yeah, if they stop taking penalties now, you could say it was a good night, but still those 4 minutes of penalty time in the first period keeps you from getting your game going and keeps you from getting that momentum. And that can be detrimental, especially if you're not able to cash in on opportunities later in the game. So I think close game experience, as important as it could be to do as a team, I think if you're beating teams really well, continue beating up on teams. And I think you're going to see the Lakers start to come through in the second period as long as they can stay out of the box.
I agree, but they have played close games. The first game against Morrisville was a close game until the third period.
The Geneseo game.
Perfect example. They played close games. Wasn't Potsdam or Plattsburgh? One of those was a close game for a while.
Plattsburgh was close for a while.
I mean, more so it was 2-1 going into the third. So they played tight games throughout the year. So they have that experience, and they're able to put their foot on the gas pedal and just explode. They can't expect that always to be. They're going to have to win some tight games. But they have enough veteran leadership to do that so this year.
I completely agree. I believe playing close games, you have to look at the fine details of the game. Watching film, seeing where you should pass as opposed to where to keep the puck or where to shoot. Just all of this together, you learn from your mistakes, and it's kind of hard saying that when Oswego's has the perfect record. Now, they're not a perfect team yet by any means. They have to continue playing this well. But I just think this is a close game right now, but the way Oswego can play, it shouldn't be.
Well, it shouldn't be. We'll see if Lakers can follow and suit with that Mike Cicero and see if they have an answer for this. Scoreless first. On the other side of this break, Anthony Dolson, Jordan McGee will have the continued call of this game. Scoreless heading to the second period of Steel Hall. Lakers and Blue Devils all knotted up at zero. We'll be right back here on WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
I am Oz, the great and powerful.
You're listening to Oz Radio, 88.9 WNYO, Oswego, New York.
Who are you?
WNYO is an entirely student-run radio station located in the Point of the Campus Center at SUNY Oswego. We're open to every SUNY Oswego student. Here at WNYO, you can host your own music, talk, or sports show, join our news team, and do live play-by-play. You can even join our executive board. To get started, log on to www.wnyo889.org and click on the Connect tab. Whether you'd like to get a leg up in your field or just have some fun on the radio, there's a place for everyone here at 88.9 FM WNYO.
In a country where people are overwhelmed with school, work, and having adult responsibilities, nothing will put you in a better mood like listening to some great music. I'm Bear Mace, and I'm the host of the 80s show on 88.9. I play nothing but the best rock and roll from a decade that defined what it meant to be an American. Tune into the 80s show every Sunday night from 9 to 10, only on WNYO 88.9 FM. Laker Radio, your way.
Hey, Russell Wilson here, and I know how important exercise is.
It's essential, it's essential.
With Play 60, United Way, and the NFL are helping kids stay active and play at least 60 minutes a day.
Healthy kids, healthy kids.
But what this place needs is you. To donate or volunteer, go to unitedway.org/play60, because great things happen when we live united.
Donate, donate.
Are you guys going to do that every time?
Yes, of course, yes, of course.
Brought to you by United Way and the Ad Council.
Second period, where players dash with skates aflash, the home team trails behind, but they grab the puck and go bursting up, and they're down across the line. They storm the crease like bumblebees, they travel like a burning flame. We see them slide the puck inside, it's a 1-1 hockey game.
And we're back just before the start of the second period of action from Steel Hall as the Oswego State Lakers take on the Fredonia Blue Devils. And still no score here after one period. Anthony Dolson and Jordan McGee with you now. And Jordan, like we said, it was a pretty exciting period.
It was a pretty exciting period. You know, we've been, used to, I guess, scoring. And we've seen the Lakers score before and then a bad period. Well, that's not the case. We're getting a much more even game. Yeah, it looks like it's the way that first period went, we're going to have a much more even game here throughout the rest of these next two periods. And it's very interesting to see the line combinations, because really, in my mind, I don't think any one line really stood out in that first period.
I thought the Botten-Neil-Holshoff line had a great shift at the end of the first. And if anyone's going to stand out, by default, it's going to be that one. So
only, of course, all in that one, but... Yeah.
And I think Fleur and Huffnagel are actually playing their normal game. Both of them always have their feet moving. Huffnagel looks creative. He looks better.
Yeah, if he was a right back, he'd be peeking all the time. He has these great moves, but he does a little bit too much. We saw it in that first period alone. He was trying to pass the defender and create that chance all alone, but too many moves, and, Fredonia was able to poke that one away. So we're still scoreless. Wanted to see now with the start of the power play, with a minute 38 left to go here on this power play, can the Lakers get an early goal to start the second?
Botten did police on the opening faceoff of the second period. We are underway. It's won by Botten. Minute and a half on this Laker power play, brought to you by Steve's Farm Market and River Center. From the right wing to Botten. Botten shifts it in deep, chases it himself. He's met there by Young. Botten shifts it behind an L shot, banked it along the far or the near board, excuse me, once again. Goes back to the point, Johnson. Johnson over the glory goal, and never that one. Hit a man in front, hit J.D. Young, and he's on the ice. Back to the point, Galati, to Johnson. Johnson, Botten, near side, face-off circle. Botten, skates to the slot. Now skates to the far side. Holshoff now in the high slot. Near face-off circle with a shot. That one's going to deflect and go up and out of play. We're going to get our first stoppage in play with 19:24 to go here in the second period, a minute to go on the power play.
Yeah, Jamie Young is coming off the ice. A little bit bruised. It looks like he's holding his hand, and so he will head to the bench as he looks like he blocked a shot right there. But good start for there for Fredonia. They're taking away all the all the way to the shooting lanes here to start that power play. Just one consistent movement to negate any shooting lane.
Blue Devils win the faceoff and try to clear. They cannot. It's held in by the Lakers and Ragusea with the point. Hurley near side. Hurley back to the far side point. Ragusea with a long shot. Bogart chops that one. Rebound is loose in front. It's going to be cleared back down the ice by the Blue Devils defense. Kowalski is going to leave it there for Joey Rutkowski.
And there was a couple rebounds left cut out in front tonight for Bogart, but Fredonia was, again, every time has been able to see the puck and just clear it right out in front away from Bogart.
Ragusea chipped it behind the net. Barton has it there. Barton has it checked away from him, but Hurley comes to pick him up. Set up in the far corner, and Hurley digs it free. Hurley back to the point, Ragusea. Far side, now near side for Rutkowski. Rutkowski back to the top, Ragusea. Ragusea now shoots just wide. Be held in by the Lakers. Hurley spins away in the far corner. Hurley back to the top. Stops, starts, now gets it back down low. Back to the point once again, Hurley. Now puts to the top for Rakowski with a long slap shot. Bogart stops that one. Rebound kicked out wide. Held in by the Lakers and Mitch Hurley. Hurley tries to get it up to Sullivan. It's held in by Barton. As the Blue Devils return to full strength, Barton tries to take it down low. Left it for Sullivan. Sullivan back to the point for Rakowski. Rakowski over to Regaseo. Regaseo near side. Sends it back down low. Behind Bogart. Comes all the way along the boards. Now far side. Barton got tangled up with Cassell. Now Barton has the puck. He sends it back behind the net. It's taken by Scognardi. Blue Devils skate back with it. This is Schaus. Schaus on the left wing is hit by Rakowski. He just dodged it. Behind the net now is Davies. His own net left it for Regaseo. Regaseo, stretch pass off the boards. Just missed Huffnagel. It's going to go all the way down the ice for an icing. Another stoppage in play. 17:48 to go here in the second period.
A nice job by the penalty killing unit there for Fredonia. Again, taking away every one of those passing lanes and clearing it right away. Fredonia, again, playing a really great game and giving the Lakers a lot of trouble, as well as Eric Bogart. Every time he's been faced with a shot, he's just able to redirect it off into the corners. That's what you want to see out of your goaltender.
Faceoff to the right of Zawadzki is won by the Lakers. Regaseo has it behind the net. Regaseo tries to clear, not out, held in far side by the Blue Devils to get it back behind. Rakowski has it. Rakowski for Davies. Tried to chip it off the boards, held in by Sean Leonard. Goes behind the net once again. Blue Devils have it there. Says Dunn. Dunn gets checked. Regaseo takes it away. Sends it up, and the Lakers set the rush back. Emerson to Huffnagel. Huffnagel on the left wing. Throwing it back to his stick. Now trying to toe drag for Emerson now. Loose, still loose in front. Emerson's taken down. I believe there's going to be a penalty here on someone. Looks like it might be the Blue Devils.
And again, we're seeing that right there. Mitch Emerson, any player coming right in at Bogart is just going to get checked right away with the body, no, with the stick right in front for Fredonia.
I was wrong. It's not a penalty. It was just an offside.
So, but nonetheless, we keep seeing that the Lakers going in on right out in front of Bogart, just attacking the net right there to start off the second period with Emerson going right at him. It's going to be tough to go after someone like Bogart with the size that he has.
So it's going to be Botten on the faceoff. Wilbur's going to get tossed. It's going to be Jimmy Morgan now. Take on Botten. Near side outside the Blue Devil end. It's taken by the Lakers. Johnson fires it in from center ice. Here's Jamie Young. Young banks it off the glass. Tries to clear it, but does not. Now the Blue Devils carry it out. Banked off the boards. Far side as Botten corrals it behind his own net. Botten's taken to the boards right there by Polacek. The Lakers try to start back. MacMillan with a backhand pass up along the boards. Held in by the Blue Devils for the moment. MacMillan has it in the far corner of his own end. Now he gets it to Johnson. Johnson, pass up to Botten, tipped along, couldn't get it out. Johnson's got it back. MacMillan across ice, far side. MacMillan, stretch pass, tried to get it to Holshaw, but went off him. Turned back over at center ice. Now the Blue Devils might have a 2-on-1. And they can right wing side, tried to pass across the ice, but it was knocked away by Johnson. Johnson got it up to Holshaw, left it for Botten. Botten digs it free, takes it up the left wing. Botten with a long shot. Bogart stops that one. It's going to go out of play for a stoppage. 16:36 to go in the second. Still no score.
And again, we're seeing a little bit of a flat line from this Oswego offense here to start the second. You know, every time they've tried to get a shot, Bogart's just been able to be smart about it and save it. And same with a little bit for Fredonia. They've been kind of coming out a little flat, too. They haven't had a lot of good chances, or really any chances at all, to start off against Zawadzki. So both offenses kind of trying to find something here to start the second.
Long face-off and a long shot from the point off the face-off is knocked away by Bogart. Lakers hold it in for the moment, but the Blue Devils come up with it. Ortiz now up in the left wing to Haynes. Haynes is knocked away. Taken away by Spagnardi. Spagnardi from center right fires it on in. It goes behind Zawadzki. Zawadzki can't play it. It's going to come along the board, near side boards to Federo. Up now to Hurley. He banked it off the glass. Got it up to center right. Barton tries to knock it down. Can't. Hurley tries to take it away. Ortiz is in over the line, but he was edged off by Federo. Brunn tries to knock it to the corner. Now it's clear back in front, but Zawadzki's going to put a glove over that one and prevent any further chances. 16 to go here in the second.
Brunn a little bit waxed the days ago on that one as he had the puck and that just kind of drifted over to Ortiz, who was able to try to get a shot on Zawadzki. Didn't know if Brunn just wasn't aware of where the puck was or whatever the case may be, but nonetheless, it's Fredonia getting closer and closer to trying to get one on the board, and they've been coming up close.
Faceoff won by the Lakers to the left of Zawadzki. Regaseo comes up with it. Regaseo tries to pass it off the glass to Ferreira, but it's going to hit him. And no icing here. Max Ross behind his own net. Tries to clear it along the board. Held in by Regaseo, far side. Regaseo is checked by Schaus. It goes behind the net once again. Water Street takes his man to the ice. Water Street takes the puck free. Got it back to the point. Regaseo with a one-timer. That one didn't get through. Rebound was loose in front. Sullivan tried to tip it. It comes along the near side wall now. Ferreira tries to take it free. Blue Devils come up with it. And they can't get an alley to get it out. And here's Schaus. Schaus along the right wing. Long shot. Goes wide. Held in
now by Jelinski. Jelinski's checked behind the net, but he comes up with the puck again. Jelinski in the corner now. He finds Schaus back behind the net, knocked down by Regaseo. Regaseo to Ferreira. Ferreira tries to chip it out and does. Got it back to center ice, fired right back in on the Blue Devils. Takes a weird hop off the glass, but Rakowski was there to play it. Rakowski up to Ferreira. Ferreira tried to get it in deep, and here's Davies. Davies tried a long shot. That one went wide. It's going to come back out of the leak, or the Fredonia end. McMillan's going to misplay it in his own end. Comes up with it, though. Has to evade a check. Gets it out. Now he turns it over at center ice. Here's McAvoy. McAvoy on the left wing with a shot. Blocker stopped by the left. He comes loose beside the Blue Devils. Score! Buried off the rebound chance. I believe McAvoy might have gotten that one, and the Blue Devils are going to take a 1-0 lead.
Well, it looks like that goal might be credited to Ryan Dunn.
And it is. You're right, Jordan.
Ryan Dunn has McAvoy created the shot along the near side board. Zawatsky tried to redirect it off into the far side corner, but Dunn was right there to pick up the rebound, and just like that, Fredonia strikes first here in this game. They're up 1-0, and Lakers find themselves down for the first time in what it feels like a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, they have not trailed in quite some time.
And so now here it is, another chance to overcome adversity with 14:43 left to go in the second.
The faceoff is won by the Lakers. Neal gets it into the Fredonia end, but it's taken by Young. Young tries to loft it out and does get it back out to center ice. McMillan across to Johnson. Johnson, pass up left wing. Neal for Botten. Botten tries to skate in, got it the whole shot, but the near faceoff circle with a shot. That one is blocked. Lakers are able to hold it in. It's going to be knocked down in the near corner. Holeshoff's going to try to dig it free. It's behind the net now along the far side. Neal has it in the corner. Neal back down behind for Botten. Botten. Got a backhand pass across, goes behind the net. Holeshoff comes up with it. Holeshoff. Back to the point, McMillan. McMillan sends it right back down low. It's going to come all the way along the far side. Johnson's going to pinch and try to hold that one in. To fight off a check from Morgan. Comes loose beside the net again. Carlson's going to try to clear. He can't do it yet. And now the Blue Devils come up with it, and they're going to have a 3-on-2 if they hurry. And over the line now, since Polacek with a long shot, Zawatsky makes a stop. Lakers try to clear. It hits a few bodies. Can't get out. McMillan tries to clear. Still trying to kick it free. Tied up right outside the Blue Devils bench. This is going to be a break for the Blue Devils. Joaquin with a shot. The rebound so loose in front. Zawatsky knocks it away. Back to the point. Spagnardi with a long shot. Doesn't get through. Knocked out of the crease. And Neal's going to try to get after it, but Spagnardi's going to beat him. He's going to send it over to Cassell. Cassell in his own end. 13:30 to go in the second period. Fredonia leads 1-0. Stretch pass hits a man. Morgan's able to backhand it in. It's going to go behind the net for Johnson. Johnson for McMillan. Up on the right wing, Galati deflected out to center ice. It's knocked down by Sean Leonard, who backhands it right back into the Laker end. Here's McMillan again. Spins away from a check, got it over to Johnson. Johnson, pass up left wing side. It hits a stick, and it's fired right back into the Laker end. Off to Watsky. McMillan has it again. McMillan behind for Johnson. Johnson behind his own net with 13 to go in the second. Steven Johnson again. Bang pass off the boards, misses Mitch. Oh, hey, it's going to go all the way down the ice for an icing against the Lakers. Faceoff goes back and will probably beat to Matt Zawatsky's right.
And speaking of Matt Zawatsky, that probably would have been almost goal number two for Fredonia if it weren't for Zawatsky just poking that puck after the initial shot from Schaus. A rebound out in front, and Zawatsky just uses his stick to just poke it out towards the blue line. So Fredonia is up on their feet, and they were dangerously close to making a goal number two here in the second period.
Fredonia comes up with the puck, try to clear it in front, hit a skate, goes off into the far corner again. Blue Devils hold it in, Jelinski back to the point with a long shot, the twist, and they score! That's Todd Schaus in front of that with a redirect, and just like that, the Blue Devils up 2-0.
And what a little bit of a shock right here, as there's a good amount of Oswego fans in the crowd, as that, like you said, redirected and just right down, and Patton Fredonia up 2-0 on the number one team in the nation, and this might be a time for a timeout here if I were the coaching staff, because, again, the Lakers are down here. Again, they haven't had this kind of adversity since the Geneseo game back at home over a month ago, but they are down, and Oswego definitely needs an answer here soon.
Here, the puck comes along the far side of the Laker end, try to clear it in front. It hits Zawatsky. He's going to cover up. That was almost a third goal.
That's almost a third goal. I would really recommend, I would have to think that the coaching staff needs a timeout just to kind of
rally the troops
and just break up this momentum right now for the Blue Devils, because they are just attacking Zawatsky consistently and all the way through.
Shot off the faceoff, hits a man, knocked down in front. Federer was able to clear it back out to center ice. Hammers right back into the Laker end. Picked up by Jody Sullivan. Sullivan up now. Brunn gets it out up to Water Street. Water Street takes it in over the blue line on the left wing. Water Street. Ferreira from the slot. That one bounced wide. Ferreira chases it in the near corner, left it behind the net for Water Street. Water Street bites off a check. takes it to the half wall. He's going to have it knocked off his stick. Now it's tied up, still on the near wall. Still being battled for. It's knocked out at the point by Federer. Water Street keeps it in forever from the slot. That was a shot that was blocked and went wide. Dunn, who has the first Fredonia goal, sends it back behind the net. As Blue Devils try to clear. And this is going to be a penalty, I believe, on Jody Sullivan.
Things are starting to unravel here in the second period for Oswego. Yep, Jody Sullivan tended to the box, and that's the third penalty here in this game. First of the second period, and the last thing you want to do is give Fredonia a power play opportunity down 2-0 here with 11:54 left to go. And again, a Fredonia team that ranks in the top five in power play in the country.
Faceoff to the right of Zawatskis, won cleanly by the Lakers. Regaseo fires it all the way along the boards. It'll go back down the ice to the Fredonia end. This penalty kill brought to you by Sees Farm Market and Beverage Center.
And this is the PK unit right now. Again, a top PK unit in the country that's going to need to come up big here. Down 2-0. They're going to need to shake off this power play.
Botten's going to send it back down into the Fredonia end. Blue Devils will reset. Polacek's going to pick it up. Polacek is behind Bogart, left it there. Now the Blue Devils start their way back. Skurhardson. Skurhardson across the left wing. Fires it into the Laker end, far corner. Regaseo's going to come up with it, and he's going to clear it right back down the ice. Just missed Botten on what would have been a breakaway. I don't think Bogart felt Botten there at all. Bogart played it along the boards, up back to Skurhardson. Skurhardson. Touch pass across the ice. Taken in by the Blue Devils, and a shot by Ortiz up and over the net. As I believe that one was Hurley from his knees, is able to clear it back down the ice. So we have a minute to go on the power play here in the second period. Behind the net, as the Blue Devils reset. Behind their own net. This is taken back the other way. Left there for Casale. Casale across center ice. Fires it in from center ice on the far side. Comes to the near side boards now. Wilbur's in there on the forecheck with Johnson. Johnson tries to knock it down. Came loose beside the net. Now it's on the net for the moment, and the Blue Devils take it free. Lakers are going to try to clear. Hurley couldn't handle it. Now it's going to be held in by the Blue Devils once again. Behind Zawatski, Brun's going to take it away, and he's going to fire it up along the boards. Held in by the Blue Devils. Far wall. Rolled one in on Zawatski. Held in by the Blue Devils again. Behind the net. Carlson sent it there. It's to Haynes. Haynes got it back to the point. Casale knocks it back deep. And Johnson's going to be able to clear it back out. The Devils might get one last rush on the power play. This pass is almost behind the defense. Deep Elise couldn't come up with it. Now it's held in by the Blue Devils again. Haynes tried to get it, but Hurley on the back check was able to steal it away and banks it off the glass all the way back down the ice. That's going to do it for the penalty kill. Lakers perfect tonight, 3-for-3. We're halfway through the game here in the second period as the Blue Devils are up 2-0, both goals in the second period, as we're going to get an icing against the Blue Devils with 9:47 to go.
Well, other than that, you know, nice penalty kill right there by Oswego. This period's been all Fredonia so far. They've been just very impressive of how they're playing so far. They're getting their chances when they need to. They're converting in on rebounds and, you know, Oswego, again, still flat. We haven't seen that offense get any spark or any jump so far here in this period.
Well, Huffnagel's going to try to get to the starter. Tries to stick Kittle out in front, tried to take it to the net, but it was knocked away. McMillan's going to hold it in with a pinch. Now it's going to come back out to center ice. Federer's going to pick it up. Federer, pass up on the wing. Emerson tries to knock it down and can't. Now he knocks his man to the ice. Federer on the far wall, sits it back behind his own net for McMillan. McMillan, left it for Huffnagel. Huffnagel banked it off the boards, turned it over. Here's Leonard. Leonard from center ice is going to loft one immediately out of play into the meshing. We're going to have the stoppage in play, 9:18 to go.
And so right now for Oswego, you got to hope that at the top line of Neil Bonn-Holshoff comes out. It looks like that's what's going to be the case.
They need a goal back.
If they're going to score, it's going to be that top line to get things going. And they're going to need that top line of Neil Bonn-Holshoff to generate something. They've so far through two periods have been the only line that's been able to get close to getting any scoring opportunity. So this line's going to need to start figuring out a ways to get pucks on net.
Faceoff is won by the Blue Devils. Lakers come up with it in their own end. Regaseo sends it back out to center ice. Just misses Holshoff. It's going to be a foot race. Holshoff's going to win it. No icing. Holshoff tried to center back out in front, but Bogart's going to just leap on that one using all of his 6-6 frame. 9 to go. And I wonder if the coaching staff would consider putting Water Street back with Ferreira and Huffnagel. So putting Huffnagel back on that line, because that line can generate chances.
It could generate chances, but it also could, you know, it's a risk and reward line. And right now, I think the risk is outweighs the reward right now, especially in the situation down 2-0 here.
Based off one by the Lakers, it's back down low for Neil. Neil spins away in the far corner. Still got the puck. Sends it back down behind. Botten now picks it up there. Botten on the far half wall. Back to the point, Regaseo. Chips it back down low, but it hits a Blue Devil player, and now the Blue Devils come back the other way. At center ice now, to Spagnardi, sends it back into the blue belt, or the Laker end, excuse me. Zawadzki left it behind the net, didn't feel Morgan, and it came loose in front. It was not Morgan, it was Polacek. Spagnardi holds it in, and he's just going to shoot it right out of play again. It's really low, what we're seeing more pucks go out of play, I feel like, than normal.
It's a little bit lower, the netting here, in Fredonia. It looks like it looks to appear that way, as the glass isn't very tall here in Fredonia, so
yeah.
A lot of netting.
It's like all half wall.
It pretty much is all half wall and very low glass, so pucks easily go into the netting, but maybe a good thing to kind of just break up the momentum that Fredonia has created here in this second.
Face off to the right of Zawadzki is won by the Lakers, but Ortiz holds the puck into the blue levels along the far wall. Wrestling with Herlihy, now it's dug free. And the net tried to clear it in the slot, but Galati was able to take it away. Barton skates back. Barton spins back in the zone end. Pass cross ice to McMillan. McMillan, pass up on the right wing. Galati's going to chip it in. But he's not going to chip it in. It's going to go back down the ice for an icing.
Well, you can play a little game right now here, folks, at home. It's the icing game. And
the icing game and the puck going over the glass game.
Pretty much at this point. But, again, like I said, maybe a good thing to just slow down Fredonia right now because of all the momentum they've created for themselves.
I would argue this works against the Lakers because they're used to playing fast without a lot of stops. So this might be throwing them off their rhythm a little bit. Faceoff is one. Galati chips it back out to center ice. Johnson's going to just go after it right himself. He's a one-man forecheck. The Devils are able to spin away and get it back into the Laker end. McMillan back up to Herlihy on the left wing. Back to Galati. Just missed him on a pass. Goes into the near side boards of the Blue Devil end. Barton digs it free. Tried to get it behind the net. Still being battled for. Herlihy in the far corner. Herlihy at the faceoff circle. Back to the point. Johnson can't quite play. It comes back out to center ice. Johnson tried to pass. It hit Schaus, who's going to battle with Johnson. Johnson's going to be taken down by Schaus. Schaus didn't know where the puck was, though. It's chipped back along by McMillan up to Herlihy. Herlihy off the glass. Comes back out to center ice. Spagnardi knocks it down. Tried to clear it back into the Laker end, but Herlihy dug it free. Herlihy to Galati, as the Lakers are going to be very, very, very offside.
Galati was trying to chip that one to Herlihy, and Herlihy just went way offside on that one, like you said. And 7:26 left to go. So I'm trying to get over a lot of the music here. And something's happening.
Yeah, something is going on.
Someone's getting away a pizza, I guess?
I don't know. Either way, the Lakers from the faceoff off the outside. 7:20 to go here in the second period. Fredonia up 2-0. Water Street can play it. Now it's taken away by Ferreira. Ferreira. Pass off the boards. Water Street's able to control it, but he has it knocked away. It's sent back down the ice into the Laker end. And this is going to be an icing against the Blue Devils with 7 minutes to play. Still 2-0. Blue Devils is, like we're saying, we're just waiting for the Lakers to get that spark that they always get. They've had a couple chances, but not up to their normal standards.
Yeah, I mean, again, we've kind of seen them in this situation before. Again, I keep pulling back to that Geneseo game where for two periods they were outplayed by the Knights, and third period they were able to turn it on, but you'd hope that the Lakers wouldn't wait till the third to get something going.
Neal with a shot from the slot that hit the goalpost. As now it comes back to the point, Johnson sends it back down, Botten along the near wall, as Neal is able to knock it free. Blue Devils still trying to clear. We're going to get a whistle and a stop, saying the puck is going to be knocked down with a high stick, and I believe it's going to stay in the Blue Devil end.
And second time tonight, Kenny Neal has hit the post once again. Neal just getting so close to scoring, just inches that puck moves a little bit over, and then you have yourself the goal. So Kenny Neal doing all he can, but it's just bad luck, and Bogart might want to just tap the post right or tap the pipe, as that's his best friend so far, as Kenny Neal again getting two opportunities to score once again.
Faceoff is won by the Lakers, but it hits a skate and goes back out to center ice. In his own end is Ragusea. Pass up the whole shot. He's able to deflect it on into the Blue Devil end. It's going to be taken by Sean Leonard. Behind the net, he's back-checked by Holshoff. The Devils try to clear. Tied up along the near wall. Johnson's going to try to send it back down low. It's knocked down at center ice by Ragusea. Ragusea, backhand pass. Got out to Botten. Botten's going to skate in. He's going to leave it for Neal. Chips it across the Holshoff and just missed. It's like a corner kick in soccer, and back start the Blue Devils. Coming back the other way, up on the right wing side. Morgan is decked to the ice by Ragusea, and that shot right on goal off the stick of Sam Wilbur is stopped by Zawadzki. So nice stop there, and nice hit by Ragusea.
Nice hit by Ragusea, and you know, again, we're looking for that spark plug. Not just a goal, but a moment. Something here in the second period to get that bench fired up and get this team going. And you're waiting for that moment, that play, that hit, something for Oswego to get the energy back up and get this game going, and that might be it.
That I don't know how that wasn't a penalty, but I'm not going to complain. Davies just took his man to the boards hard. It's going to go in the far corner of the Laker, and Brun's going to dig it for. He's going to have it taken away by Ortiz. But a long soft shot. Zawatsky puts that one in his chest and is able to make that stop. I don't know how Davies didn't get a boarding goal.
That was close. It's one of those calls that just...
Looked like a hit from behind, at least. I don't...
The refs just didn't see it, and fortunate enough, it's the last thing, again, the Lakers need is a penalty, but big hits, and then Zawatsky making saves right in the chest. He's got to hold down that four well, because Fredonia has been putting up on the offensive pressure here tonight, alone in the second period.
Face-off won by the Lakers to Zawatsky's left. Blue Devils are going to come up with the puck and fire a long shot. It's going to go right back into the mesh. I don't like this half-ball.
This half-ball is creating a lot of
stops
and starts, and there's only so many things you can say in 4 seconds of hockey analysis. Unfortunately, I don't have much to say. I'm at 4 seconds of hockey play. I got another face-off right in front of Matt Zawatsky.
It's going to be to his right. Barton's going to get tossed. Galati's going to come in to take it now. He's going to face Tommy DeFelice. Galati's going to win it. Erlehe's going to try to dig it free. Weak angle shot from the Blue Devils goes wide. Barton tips it back out to center ice. The Devils try to get it back into the Laker end. They come up with it. It's Casale. Backhand pass across to Spognardi. Spognardi fires it on in. It's going to go behind Matt Zawatsky. Johnson's going to try to play it. He's going to leave it for Rutkowski. Barton gets checked along the far wall of his own end. Blue Devils hold the puck in, still being battled for. Dug free again by the Lakers. 5 minutes to go here in the second period. Lakers trail 2-0. Johnson chips it up, got it to Hurley. Hurley and his teammate collide. It was Barton. Now Barton's in over the line. Had it knocked up his stick. Barton trying to skate free. Galati digs it free. Galati back to the point. Rutkowski with a shot. That stopped by Bogart. Galati's trying to dig it free in the corner. Hurley comes up with it back to the point again. Rutkowski sends it back down low for Galati. Sends it behind the net. Barton's going to chase it, and he's going to come up with it. Barton, near side, back to the point for Johnson. Johnson spins away from his man nicely. Johnson at the faceoff circle, lost control of the puck. This might be a break the other way, but Fredonia man falls. It was DeFelice. Barton with a diving effort is going to clear it away. Zawatsky's going to play behind the net, bank it off the glass, got it back up to Johnson. Johnson, spin off the boards. Ferreira has it. Dave Ferreira along the right wing, pulls up with a shot. That one's going to take a bounce up in front of the net, knocked down by the Blue Devils. But Ferreira's going to turn the wraparound, it was loose in the crease, and Bogart's going to put a glove over that one. Now we got a little bit of extracurriculars, and who else would be in the middle of that but Chris Waterstreet?
Chris Waterstreet, 6'5", above him. Get a little bit of confrontation, but I'll go back to it. The Lakers losing the puck a lot tonight. Going into the zone, they're trying to attack, and they just lose possession of the puck. And that has created almost a couple opportunities for Fredonia to take it back the other way with two-on-ones or two-on-nones so far in this game. So Lakers got to try to be able to hold on to that puck as they're driving into the crease, into the low post.
Chase up one by the Lakers again. It's back behind. Ferreira tries a backhand, didn't get through. Sullivan was knocked down. Blue Devils come up with it behind the net and try to clear it. Held in by Sullivan. Back to the point. Regasero with a slap shot. That one just tipped wide. Young comes up with it, tries to clear again. Regasero tries to hold it in. Comes back out to center ice. MacMillan's going to play it. Going to get it back up. He's going to turn it over. Young for Carlson. Back in the zone end, near side. Carlson. All the way up the ice. Regasero is able to knock it down. He's going to fire it into the Blue Devil end. Behind Bogart. Ferreira's going to dig it free. Ferreira tried to get it back to the point. Couldn't get a pass off. Ferreira's knocked down. No call. Blue Devils come back the other way and over the line. Morgan tried to leave it in the slot. Shot just tipped wide off the stick of Polacek. Zawatsky's on the ice again. He's back up. And we're going to get a penalty against the Lakers here. Might be a hook.
And again, another penalty. The problems of penalties continues on from last weekend's series against Morrisville.
Maybe it's not a penalty. I don't see anyone in the box. It's not a penalty. The third time that's happened to me tonight. Whatever.
Never mind. It looked like the call, the ref had his arm up.
As soon as the Lakers touched the puck, so I don't know what the stoppage was, but the faceoff is going to be to the left of Zawatsky. Still 5-on-5. Won by the Lakers. Holshoff has it. Front of his own net, takes it out. Tried to get it to Water Street, but he wasn't paying attention. And it's fired right back in by the Blue Devils. Behind Zawatsky. MacMillan tries to play it up the wall to Holshoff. Knocked down. Water Street's in there. The far corner of his own end, spins it back behind the net. Spognardi tries to play it, but Regasello comes up with it. Now Water Street tries to chip it up the boards. Holshoff got it free to center ice. Sullivan comes in. Left wing. Sullivan at the faceoff circle with a long shot. Bogart stops that. Goes off in the corner as the Blue Devils come up with it. Lofted back out to center ice. back behind Zawadzki. Now, no icing here. Brun is kicking the glass hard. That's going to be a boarding penalty. That has to be. Lakers throw the puck. Here's Federer. Federer up now to Botten. Botten into the line of the shot, knocked away. He's going to roll to Bogart. He's going to dive on that one. This is going to be a power play easily for the Lakers. I know I'm not wrong about this one.
No, definitely not. Ortiz hit his man right there. A much needed power play for the Lakers.
They need a spark here.
They need a spark, and this is where they could get that spark. It's 2:54 left to go here in the second. It'll be a 2-minute power play. As a promotion right here, going on in Fredonia, but again, this is what they need right here. If they can get a goal here, they're going into the second intermission, it's going to give them a big sigh of relief and a lot less weight on their shoulders going into the intermission. So you got to get that top power play unit, and it's going to have to start with the seniors of Neil Botten and Holshoff.
Face off to the right of Eric Bogart, top power play unit on for the Lakers. Power play brought to you by Sees Farm Market and Beverage Center. 3 minutes to go here in the second period. Still 2-0 Blue Devils. Back to the point, it's Johnson. Johnson to Holshoff, near side. Doesn't shoot. Gets it back to Botten at the top. Botten skates it into the circle. Back to the top, Johnson. For a Galani one-timer, Bogart. Might have gotten a piece of that one. Might have went wide. Lakers hold it in. Here's Botten again along the near wall. Cross ice to Galani. Tipped it back to Johnson with a one-timer. Didn't get through. Botten has it in front. Back to Galani. Galani can't play it. And it's thrown away. This might be a break the other way. And it's looking that way for the Blue Devils with a slap shot. Zawadzki stops that one. It's up a stick of Sam Wilbur. Now a stretch pass back up to Holshoff. Holshoff, right wing side, takes it in over the line, stops in the near corner. Holshoff, back to the point again, Johnson. Johnson to Galani. Back across to Holshoff, couldn't play it, but he got it to Botten. Botten back to the top, Johnson. Near side again, Botten. Botten cleared it across, tried to get it to Neal in the slot, just missed, and Johnson back to Botten in the faceoff circle. In the slot to Holshoff and Neal, and it's now fired right back down the ice by the Blue Devils. Zawadzki's going to play it behind the net. Minute to go in the power play, 2 minutes to go in the period.
The Fredonia formation, they have four men down low right in front of Boga. They're just, any time they're going right into the low slot area, Fredonia Blue Devil player is able to pick it up and just send it down the other way.
Burkowski's going to toss it into the Blue Devil end. Young's going to play it in the corner. Comes free, try to get it back to the point. Regaseo is able to keep it in. He's going to get it to Herlihy along the far half wall. Now Young has it behind his own net. He's going to fire it along the boards. Rakowski's going to hold it in. So Rakowski at the top to Regaseo. Regaseo, once again at the top of Rakowski. Over to Herlihy. Tried to clear it in front. He's losing the slot. Bogart's going to cover up that one. Might have hit a skate and rolled right on him, but no dice there. We're going to get another faceoff with a minute 25 to go in the second period. 30 seconds to go on the power play.
Eric Bogart making another big save here tonight for Fredonia. And, you know, right out in front of here, again, another power play he has to face. And Bogart was able to jump on that one. It's going to be tough trying to find where exactly can they strike past Bogart. They're going to have to make him move from post to post and catch him looking the other way.
Faceoff won by the Lakers. Whole shot at the faceoff circle. Fired a shot. Didn't get on goal. Held in, though, by the Lakers for the moment. Blue Devils try to come up with it. Neal is the back check. Keeps it in. Now it's in that near corner to Neal. Neal takes it down low. Behind the red line now. Pulls up. He's in Gretzky's office. Now for across to Galani with a shot. Hit Bogart, and the Blue Devils strip it right back down the ice. That's basically going to do it for the power play for the Lakers. As there's a minute to go here in the second period, Blue Devils lead 2-0. Pass up on the right wing. It hits Botten. Rolls back to center ice. Carlson fires it right back on in. Johnson's going to play it behind his net. Johnson up to Botten. Botten and over the blue line on the right side. Botten from the high slot with a shot. Didn't get through. Rebound. Almost came free. Federer with a shot on goal. They score! Sean Federer put it on goal. It was hit by someone. I'm not sure who. Might have been Holshoff. Might have been Neal. Either way, the Lakers cut the deficit in half. It was Holshoff.
And again, a much needed goal. Sean Federer, sorry up that play. He's going to get the assist and his first game back in a while. And Sean Holshoff is able to tip it in the other way. And the Lakers get a much, much needed goal to make this a one goal deficit with 40 seconds left to go here in the second. And boy, did the Lakers really need a goal right there.
That was absolutely huge for the Lakers. Right before the start of the third, it's rolled back down to Zawadzki, just wide of him. Brun's going to play it, and we're going to get a stoppage in play.
I'm not even
going to guess on these anymore because I don't even know.
It looks like they're going to
bring it
all the way back to center ice.
All the way back to the Blue Devils. So it's got to be an icing.
Icing. The very delayed, not clear in front of us icing, but nonetheless, another icing right there. So 32 seconds left now to go here in the second period.
Davies on the faceoff. Excuse me, that's Botten. He's top line once again on for the Lakers. Botten tries to send it in front. The whole shot has it behind it up for Neal. The faceoff circle with a shot. Didn't get it on goal. Neal takes a freezing shot. They score! The real deal, Kenny Neal. The Lakers
get two goals in the last minute of the second period and tie the game at two.
Well, Oswego would have been happy to go down one, but now all of a sudden two quick goals, and just like that, this whole thing aside, and the real deal, Kenny Neal, and that top line strikes. We were talking about this. That first line needed to strike. It needed to happen.
Yeah, they struck twice.
They struck twice, and they're much needed. And this game is tied up. And, boy, talking about a weight getting off your shoulder for Oswego, being down 2-0 here early on in the second. They have now erased that deficit. And now, once again, they're tied up. Now they're tied up 2-2.
Davies wins the faceoff. Right? I can say, well, banks it off the glass, back into the blue double end. Leonard sends it back into center ice. And Huffnagel's going to pick it up. He's got 12 seconds. Huffnagel. With Mitch Emerson. Emerson pulls up, shoots, didn't get through. Rebound comes loose. Tried to get it on goal with Johnson. Couldn't do it. Johnson holds it in. And it's going to go off along the far wall. Johnson with a last-minute slap shot. Huffnagel tried to put it on goal, just went wide. That's going to do it for the second period. As that last minute turned things around.
Big time. It looks like with the 1 minute left to go, it looks like Fredonia was going to come in with a big advantage going into the third. But
no advantage at all.
No advantage at all, and they needed that two-goal advantage on the number one team in the country. But just like that, Oswego has been down before, and they've done it again. They get down and they respond, and they did there with two goals in the last minute of play in that period. And now it's 2-2, and this is going to be one heck of a third period to go into it. As you know, we saw Fredonia get the advantage early on. Now momentum just swung right back the other way for Oswego, and now we have a 2-2 game going into the third. It should be a very entertaining final period of play here in Fredonia.
That was one of the best, most entertaining minutes of hockey I've ever seen in my entire life. So, good way to close out the second period. I'm looking forward to the third. We got about 15 minutes until then. At the end of two periods, the score tied up at two. Anthony Dolson, Jordan McGee will be back for you for the start of the third. Until then, back to Sam Watkins and the rest of the guys in the studio for your intermission report. You're listening to Laker Hockey here on WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
Why are there so many cats in this alley?
That is a great question, and do you want to know what the answer is? I will tell you. Here's the deal. Alley Cat, like the Alley Cat Show? Hello! Come on, the Alley Cat Show on Wednesdays from 12:30 p.m. to 1:45-ish.
That still doesn't answer my question.
The Alley Cat Show, only on 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
Going straight into a crazy prediction, if that's okay with everyone.
Yeah, I got it.
No.
Okay, so I predict there will be one man on the Cleveland Browns team next season, and that man will be RG3.
Alright, just RG3 running.
For more of these crazy predictions, and the occasional bit of serious football talk, listen to Around the Pylons Sunday mornings at 10 on WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
Okay, so 5 tacos of cheese and a large soda, that's $10,012. Please drive around.
Wait, 10,000 what?
It's obvious you're buzzed and driving.
I've only had a few. I'm fine.
Yeah, the food's $12, but getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Please drive around. Actually, just park and come in.
Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
The period is over, and it's time for the intermission report.
Maybe he's going to be one of these guys who rises to the occasion.
This could be a storyline that would fit this game so perfectly.
I don't care who you're facing. You can go 3 weeks without allowing a goal. It says something about the goalie.
Our guys in the studio will break down the period that was and give you the up-to-date scores in the SUNYAC out-of-town scoreboard.
I mean, the men's basketball team playing Max Zeal against Corlin right now, up 40-32 over Corlin.
It's intermission time here on WNYO 88.9 FM.
You are listening to WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way. We are in here on the Laker Intermission Report. Here in the studio with me is Mike Rifkin, Mike Cicero, and Sam Watkins. Guys, what a dramatic end to that second period. What did you guys see?
We saw a lot of shots, especially at the end from Oswego. Kind of a lackadaisical period in the beginning. They didn't get to convert on that first power play. Then they took two bad calls. I believe they killed off both penalties. And then Fredonia scored twice in a row.
Had the momentum on their side because of those penalties.
Just outplaying Oswego, short and simple. Oswego came back. They answered right at the end. Federer took a shot. Holshoff tipped it in. And then Kenny Neal.
Looked like a wraparound attempt. He just threw it and got by the goaltender. There's no reason this game should be tied, though.
No.
There's no reason. They looked terrible at the beginning of that first of that second period. Got a couple of breaks. I think the momentum changed with the second power play towards the end of the period. They got a lot of chances off. We're missing the net, but they were close a couple of times. Kenny Neal, before scoring, had hit the post a couple of times. They've had some chances, but Fredonia dominated the early part of that second period. They were lucky Matt Zawadzki was able to hold it at 2-0.
And it's interesting you say that, because it just seemed like the shots that Oswego were taking were high percentage opportunities, as you said, posts were hit. So it's definitely a weird complexion to this game. Now, Oswego scores the two late goals. Do they have the momentum moving into the third period?
Yes, they do. Scored two goals very late in the period after, like I said, not playing that well. They have a lot of momentum. Fredonia has to hope that they could score early in the third to take back the momentum that they once had in this hockey game.
Watching the game, Mike Rifkin and I were talking. The first goal from Ryan Dunn, it was a rebound shot by McAvoy. That was the first time Oswego has trailed since the Cortland game. Early mid-November on the 11th. And then going down two goals, that's the first time Oswego
has... Unheard of.
Yeah.
Geneseo. Weren't they down two goals to Geneseo?
Since Geneseo, and that was...
We know how that ended.
Our first or second week of hockey.
And, you know, guys, it's really exciting to see that this team can kind of just turn it on. You know, is it a bad thing that they kind of were asleep the first two periods, the first, let's say, 38 minutes, and then wake up for the final two? Is that a cause for concern?
I think they were trying to find a spark, and they were striking matches, and it just wouldn't burn, and then something just hit the gasoline, and Oswego burst into flames. I mean, they're just going nuts right now. High percentage shots, keeping up on the forecheck. They're keeping it in the offensive zone, which is great.
As you said, puck possession,
and they just need to back check and tighten down defensively.
Sammy, to answer your question, it is worrisome that they can sleepwalk for 38 minutes or so, because they should be ready to go at puck drop. The game started at 7 o'clock, not at 7:45, not at 8 o'clock. The game started at 7 o'clock. And once again, as Mike said, I think a big factor for them was the stop and start play. A ton of whistles. Anthony and Jordan talk about icings, the short glass, and how many pucks go out of play. And this Laker team wants to play with tempo. They like playing with tempo. When you're start and stop, you can't get that tempo going.
No, you can't. And as a coach, what can you do to get your team sparked and psyched to be able to start a game? Because this isn't the first time we've seen the Lakers kind of sleepwalk through more than a period of play.
Maybe you shake things up. A big hit wakes you up. An early goal wakes you up. I don't know what their issue is, because, you know, we sat here last week at Morrisville. What did we say after the first period? Well, the Lakers were okay. What did we say after the second? The Lakers were okay after two. And then they come out in the third and they play really well. They can't just sit back for 40 minutes and play only 20. They have to play a consistent 60-minute game if they want to continue having that goose egg in the loss column.
Absolutely. And, you know, as Sean Federer, coming back off an injury, gets a very, very big primary assist on the Holshoff goal. And, I mean, who could have predicted that one? This guy. In all seriousness, though, going into the third period, do you think Oswego keeps things going, or does Fredonia take back this game?
It's going to be interesting to see how Fredonia plays the first, I'm going to say, 5 or 6 minutes. Are they back on their heels? Are they aggressive? That's what I really want to see. I think the Lakers have to come out firing. You've got the momentum. Everything's on your side. Why not come out and just keep going forward?
I posed this question to Mike Cicero. What do you do as a coach for Fredonia to hype your guys up? I mean, you must be deflated if you're Fredonia after those final 2 minutes of the period.
You know, Oswego got two quick goals, but you have to write that off. It's a tie game right now. This game is still up for grabs on both ends. Even if you can take it to overtime, if you can match Oswego's play, or if Oswego can outperform Fredonia's play, Fredonia's the first team to have a lead against Oswego in a long time. They are playing Oswego tight. This is that tight game we were talking about after the first period intermission. I just see them saying, you know, you're still in this. Just give it all you got.
Yeah, and like I alluded to in the pregame, guys, would it be positive for the Lakers to have a close game like this? Because it had been a while since, I'd say, the Geneseo game that we saw one like this come down to the wire. So I don't think the Lakers should be happy about how they got there, and there still is plenty of work to do, considering there's still a huge 20 minutes left. I think this kind of character effort, if they can get it done, they still have a lot of work to do. But this is the kind of win, I think, that you're going to be seeing the Lakers need to score if they're going to be successful in the playoffs. You're not going to have your best of every night. It's a matter of, do you have the hustle and the effort and the character of a team to overcome that and still find a way to get the job done, even on your off nights? And so far, the Lakers have found a way to rally, so we'll see if they can continue to show this characteristic, which we didn't see at all last year. Because you guys remember last year, when the Lakers fell in the hole, that was it. 2-0, that would have been the game. So it just shows how much has changed in a year, and a win here would definitely be a huge one for Oswego State.
Now, guys, quickly, with the last minute we have of the second intermission report, if you can change your score prediction, who do you think wins this game?
I think the momentum stays the same. I think Oswego finds a way. 4-2.
I'm going to have to agree with Mike Rifkin here. 4-2. Z with a solid third period. Anything can happen. And as soon as Oswego gets one, then they can get an empty netter to finish it off.
Yeah. The Lakers always seem to tack on goals. I'm going to stick with my original prediction of 5-3. Wasn't looking good after one period, but now suddenly looks a lot better after two. So 5-3, sticking with it. How about you, Sammy? How do you feel about it?
3-3 tie should be an interesting one when you come back from break. Jordan McGee and Anthony Dulce will be on the call in Fredonia. You are listening to WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
I perform for our high school choir director, who taught me to breathe from the diaphragm and sing from the heart.
Speech, debate, theater, music. The performing arts teach valuable life lessons that typically aren't taught in the classroom. They help high school students learn leadership skills that prepare them to enjoy more satisfying, productive lives.
Hey, I've got a question for you. Who will you perform for?
This message presented by the New York State Public High School Athletic Association and the high school in your community.
Do you listen to hip-hop? Do you like throwbacks?
If you answered yes, tune in to Throwing It Back with DJ Mar and DJ Kaynard every Wednesday afternoon at 2. We play your favorite throwbacks from the 90s and early 2000s, as well as update you on current hip-hop events.
Only on WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
Third period, last game in the playoffs, too. Oh, take me where the hockey players face off down the rink, and the Stanley Cup is all filled up for the champs who win the drink. Now the final flick of a hockey stick and a one gigantic scream. The puck is in, the home team wins the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game.
And welcome back. Just before the start of the third period here from Steel Hall at SUNY Fredonia, Anthony Dulson, Jordan McGee. As it looked like the Blue Devils were going to head into the third period with a 2-0 lead, but that all changed in the last minute.
And right there, now it's going to be, like you said, it looked like It was a 2-0 lead. Fredonia had all the momentum going into what it looked like to be the final minute. And then Oswego puts up two quick goals, Holshoff score redirected off from Federal, and then Kenny Neal scoring as well. So right there, it's a tie game. All of a sudden, all the momentum that Fredonia had that they built up early on in the second period went away, and now we have a pretty much dead-even game here going into the start of the final period of play.
Yeah, and that was the craziest minute of hockey, one of the craziest minutes of hockey I've ever seen. You know, getting the one back, I was like, oh, that's huge, you know, like, cut it to half, they have the momentum, and then scored the second one. I don't even know.
Yeah, but it's funny because, you know, right now, if the Lakers are able to pull off a win here tonight against Fredonia, they just, if they can complete the comeback, we've already seen them complete the comeback against Geneseo. Could they complete a comeback here against Fredonia, too? That's, again, a team that's been able to respond to adversity. Regardless of the result, they were able to tie things up here to start the third period. So they respond well to adversity. They don't get too panicked. And like there you saw, it sometimes takes a while. You just wait for it to get your chance. And then they put it on net, and there you go. Now, granted, we didn't think the second goal was going to happen, but hey, again, the old saying is good things happen when you throw pucks on net, and they finally were able to throw pucks on net there in that final period of play. And Oswego's feeling good, but despite Fredonia giving up two goals there to start the third, they should be feeling pretty good, too. I mean, look, you got a tie game with the number one team in the nation.
Who hasn't lost a game or tied a game yet.
Exactly, on your home ice. So, you know, again, they can easily regain the lead, but we've seen Oswego in third periods take over, and we saw it, like, again, the Geneseo game. They were able to take over and take all that momentum. Will that be the case here, or are we going to have much of a grinded-out effort here for the final period of play here in Steel Hall Ice Arena?
Well, we are just about underway for the start of the third period here at Steel Hall. Zawadzki's switching up his water bottle. Cap is on the ice, so bit of a delay.
Bit of a never good sign. And speaking of Matt Zawadzki, doing his best tonight.
Yeah, I think he's actually playing very well.
Very interested to hear what Coach Davey will have to say in postgame on his thoughts on his goaltender's play.
Well, we're underway from our final period as Lakers win the faceoff. They chip it into the Fredonia end. It comes back out down to the Laker end. No icing here. Brun's going to play it behind the net. Brun for Federer. Back to Brun. Brun far side up to Holshoff. Holshoff right wing to Botten. Botten trying to get it to Neal. Just missed him. Deflected off into the corner now by the Blue Devils. Is trying to clear, not out. Held into the point by Federo. Blue Devils now knock the puck down. Chip it back down to Carlson. Carlson has it stolen away by Botten. It's back behind the net once again for Jamie Young. Young spins away from Neal. Banks one off the boards up to the left wing. This is Polacek. Polacek up now, and the Blue Devils would have been offside if they had touched that. Botten comes up with it. Or excuse me, that's Federo. Now Botten has it. Botten sends it in. Earlier he's going to come in there and chase it. Kassel has it now. Sends it back behind the net once again for Spognardi. Spognardi back to Kassel, near side, behind his own red line. Minute gone here in the third, still tied at two. Left wing to Spognardi, pass up to center ice, misses his man, goes back down the ice. McAvoy is going to try to play it. He meets Regaseo. As it goes back behind the Laker net once again, McAvoy poked along now by Hurley, but it's held in by the Blue Devils on the floor. Oh, the sharp angle shot. Knocked away by Zawadzki. McMillan able to prevent any further damage there as it's chipped up along the boards now. Barton's going to chase in after it. Barton is met there by Spognardi, who cuts him off. Now comes right in front of the net, but the Blue Devils were aware of that. And now Schaust the other way. Schaust lost control of it. Galati takes it away at center ice. Galati, and over the right wing, tried to leave it at the point, but it was a bit of a miscommunication there as the Blue Devils were able to clear it back up on the left wing to Schaust, but that went into the Laker bench. It did not, and it's corralled by Chris Regaseo. Regaseo crosses center ice and chips one on into the Blue Devil end. Pereira's chasing in after it. Or excuse me, that was Davies. Back out in front, back out to center ice, all the way back down the ice into the Laker end. As it's taken away by Rutkowski. Chipped up along now, tried to get it to Davies, couldn't do it. Almost held him by the Blue Devils, not able. But Ortiz brings it back along the right wing. Ortiz tries to take it, storms the net, backhand, didn't get through. Behind the net again is Johnson. Johnson, bang pass off the boards, got it up to center ice to Davies, sends it on in. Max Ross comes up with it for the Blue Devils, banks it off the boards to Haynes. Free at center ice once again. Emerson tried to clear one across, just missed Davies and Huffnagel. But Davies has it now with a pass up to Emerson on the left wing, deflects it on in, hits the skate, Emerson brings it in. Emerson chips it behind the net. Huffnagel's going to come up with it. He's going to knock it down in the near corner. Huffnagel back to the point. He's going to keep it himself. Takes it back to the point. Now for Johnson. Johnson near side. Back down low for Water Street. Water Street gets away from a check. Sends it back to the point for Steven Johnson. Johnson. Long shot knocked down in front. I believe it hit Emerson. Blue Devils are able to clear. They get it up to Haynes. Haynes back out to center ice. Fired back in by Brunn. Goes behind the Blue Devil net for Jamie Young. Young in the far corner. Water Street's right on him. Young battling with Water Street. Gets it up now as the Blue Devil's able to clear. Comes back out to center ice. Ferreira knocks it down. Fires it right back on in. Here's Young again. Young sends a fly ball back out to center ice. Brunn has it. Knocks it down. Stretch pass up to Water Street. Water Street. Left wing and over the line at the faceoff circle. Water Street. Tried to clear it in the slot. Just missed Sullivan on the backhand. Comes back out. Here's Polacek. Polacek crosses center ice. Tries to split the Laker defense. Unable to do that, but I thought the Blue Devils would have been onside if they had just kept that play in, but unable to do that. And here's Federow. Federow with 3.5 gone here in the third, still tied at 2. Sullivan sends one on in. It's knocked down by Spagnardi. Spagnardi behind the net. Tried a backhand pass. It hit Max Ross. Ross and Spagnardi now. Botten comes in with a head of steam. Is able to keep it in. Now comes back out to center ice, all the way down the ice, and we're going to get a stoppage of play on an icing with just about 4 minutes gone here in the third.
Water Street to Sullivan right there. It was almost that third goal right there as Water Street connected to Sullivan, but Sullivan couldn't just hold the puck down. He couldn't pull the trigger on that one. And that could have been potential goal number three tonight for Oswego. So, again, now the Lakers are, they have that offensive rhythm, and now things are starting to click here for this Lakers offense.
Faced off one by the Lakers. They keep it in to the right of Bogart. Back behind the net. Holeshoff couldn't play it along the far wall. MacMillan sends it back down low for Neal. Neal off the boards to Botten near side. Botten evades a check along the near wall. Back to the point. It's like a solid long shot. Didn't get through. Off into the far corner again. Botten comes up with it. Chips it back down behind for Neal. Neal left it for Holeshoff. Holeshoff tried to play it. Neal tried to take it to the front himself. Botten spins away with it in the far corner again. Botten along the half wall. Back down low, whole shot at the far faceoff circle. To the high slot with the shot. Bogart stops that. Regaseo keeps it in. Regaseo down very low now. Sends it back behind again. Neal tries to play it, but Max Ross comes up with it for the Blue Devils. Now it's tied up in the near corner. And it's still tied up. Still battling for it down there is Botten with Neal. Neal digs it free. Neal got it back to Regaseo at the circle. Regaseo cross ice, tried to get it to MacMillan, who can't play it, and it comes back out to center ice. MacMillan finds Holeshoff. Holeshoff up to Regaseo. Regaseo stick handles and gets it into the Fredonia end. Carlson going to have it behind his net. Carlson. Up now to Schaus. Schaus on the right wing. Cross the center ice. Lost one in. It's going to go right into the glove of Matt Zawadzki. Makes the easy catch as that's out number 1-2 to go here in the bottom of the third.
Nice little glove save there from Zawadzki. But something I've been kind of curious about is how are they going to manage the time with these lines? Because you got to imagine Neal Bongalai is going to have Neal Botten Holeshoff are going to have...
Get the Neal Botten Galati from first 3 years together. But faceoff to the left of Zawadzki is won by the Lakers. Johnson tries to spin away from his man and does. Tries to carry it out. Held him by the Blue Devils, but they whip on the one-timer. Back down to the Blue Devils' end. Bogart's going to leave it there. He's going to find Jamie Young. Young. Pass now. And front stolen by Hurley, but he fell down. Couldn't get the chance. And Young corrals the puck. Young up to Schaus. Schaus. Tries to get by Johnson and does. Comes in with a full head of steam on the right wing. Schaus has a clear in front. The puck is deflected. Knocked out of the crease by the Lakers. Hurley is going to be in a foot race. Blue Devils are able to keep it in. Here's Rakowski. Rakowski has it behind Matt Zawadzki. Rakowski. Over now to... That was Barton who lofted it in to the Fredonia. And Huffnagel's on the ice now. Lottie's out there with him. And it's up to Haynes on the right wing. Haynes crosses center ice. Evades a check from Davies. Now skates it in from the high side. What a shot. Zawadzki makes the blocker stop. Picked up by Gerhardsen. Back down low. Knocked off the puck. I believe it was Haynes again, and it was. And Federow skates away. Federow, touch pass. Out to center ice. Turns it over. Ortiz sends it right back into the Laker end. And here's Federow. Federow. Pass up to Davies. Couldn't play it. Leonard with a long shot. Zawadzki makes the easy stop. Coming up with the rebound again is Sean Federow. Federow muscles his way out. And here's Huffnagel. Huffnagel crosses center ice. Crosses the blue line. Huffnagel with a long of the shelf. Hit a man. Davies plays it along the far wall. Taken away from him, back start the Blue Devils. Skating out of their own zone now the other way. Rivera is able to knock it in. He had done with him. Federow fires it right back up to Emerson. Emerson, touch pass back up to Davies again. Davies, across the blue line, far side with a shot. Knocked down by Bogart. Huffnagel, the rebound, trying to backhand. Got it in on Bogart, who's able to make the save and cover up. 7 minutes gone here in the third period. Still
still tied at two. Joey Davies now finally getting a good scoring opportunity as he was able to kind of just dump that one, tried to dump it to Huffdangle and couldn't quite bury it. But what I was trying to finish on my last point is how much are we going to see of Neil Botten whole shop for the rest of this period? They're going to have to manage time-wise because if this team is going to get late and this game's still tied, you want that lineup to be for the majority of the period.
Face off to the left of Bogart, won by the Lakers. Sullivan takes it back down low. Sullivan along the near wall, still has the puck. Pulls up, skates back the other way, now tries to center one, but it's hit a skate, goes wide. Ferreira has it. Ferreira at the face, they're going to shot. Rebound knocked on the front. Water Street couldn't get a stick on it. Back to the Blue Devils. Polacek now up to Morgan. Morgan crosses the blue line and knocked away by Ragusea. Back behind for Ferreira. All the way along the boards now, near side. It's held in by the Blue Devils as it almost came loose in the slot. Now it's sent back off into the far corner. McMillan knocks it to Ragusea. Behind the net, here's Sullivan. Sullivan, pass up to Water Street. Water Street gets to the cross center ice, just into the Blue Devil end. Cassell knocks it back to Wilbur, back up to Cassell. Cassell skates by Water Street as he's able to chip it out to center ice. Polacek was it for Wilbur, over to Morgan. Morgan on the left wing. Got the back with a shot up and over. It goes into the mesh. We're going to get another stoppage. 12:15 to go in third. Still tied at two.
Well, so far here, 12:15 left to go in this game. So far, Oswego's had more chances in front of Bogart, and they're getting better opportunities to try to get past the pad of Bogart and trying to get better scoring opportunities, much more accurate on shots on goal here in the final period than they did start off this game.
Face off to the right of Sawatsky's, won by the Lakers. Here's Kenny Neal. Neal, stretch pass, try to get it to Botten, hit his skate. Blue Devils come up with the puck. They send it back into the Laker end, knocked down by Rakowski. Rakowski up to Botten. He can't play it. It's back behind now, held in by the Blue Devils. This is Sawatsky with a wraparound, stuffed by Sawatsky. Schaus digs it free. It's back to the point for Ross. Now Ross can't handle it. Neal has it. Neal off the glass, up the whole shot. Didn't quite get to him, and the Lakers are going to be very outside.
Yeah, try to get that pass to Holshop on the near side board. It takes a weird bounce, and Neal had to recollect it, and Holshop was offside trying to corral that puck in. So, again, we see that top line out there for a quick shift, and now we're going to see Hurley, Heave, Barton, and Galati out there trying to get something going here almost halfway through this final period of play.
Faceoff tied up, won by the Blue Devils. Young off the glass, tried to get it up to Haynes, knocked into the Laker end. Brun's going to chase after it. Hartson's right on him. Brun stops and starts. Now a pass at center ice is turned over, fired back in by Haynes. Takes a weird bounce off the boards again. Hartson tries to take it back down low. Brun's able to kick it back up to his stick, and it's back behind the Laker net for Federer. Federer to Barton. Barton, pass up now to Galati. Galati dropped it back to Hurley. He crossed center ice, got it up to Federer. Federer leading the rush, in over the line. Federer trying to dangle, take it to the net. The shot, they score! Federer got it in front, net. Galati buried it, and the Lakers take a 3-2 lead.
Well, that looks like it almost wasn't a goal as the net came off as Mornings. It looks like the refs might have called it, and Eric Bogart looking towards the ref, looking for a call as Fredonia fans are not happy as they thought that the Mornings came off its net, but nonetheless,
goal's not on the board yet.
As I think the refs are going to talk about this one because it looked like the Nets came off its morning before that one went in. But right now,
the goal's up. The goal stands. That is goal number 50 for McElhotty.
And McElhotty now 1 point away from point 100. So right there, a much needed goal as McElhotty gets that goal.
The announcer said Brun, I don't think that's right.
That is not right at all. That was 44, and he was thinking 24. That was most definitely McElhotty. We are not crazy on that one. We know what McElhotty and Christopher Brun look like. They look like very different people. That was, without a doubt, Galati score.
Suing faceoff is won by the Lakers. Back in over the line is Holshop, and along the far wall, Botten digs the free. Back to the point, Ragusea near side of the soft shot, knocked down. Goes wide of the net. Botten can't corral it, and back starts Dunn. Dunn has it kicked away from him. Botten comes up with it, sends it back into the Blue Devil end. Coming up with it now is McAvoy. Send it back out to center ice. Here's Dunn. Pass up now to Rivera. Rivera from the faceoff circle with a shot. Zawadzki makes the easy stop. Ragusea handles it behind the net as Holshop skates back the other way. Along the right wing is Sean Holshop. Skates to the middle, tried to get it to Neal and does that. Sharp angle shot. Bogart makes the easy save. Lakers come up with the rebound. Neal takes it free. Back out to Holshop. Couldn't play it through his legs. Dunn on the left wing. Lakers now lead 3-2, halfway to go here in the third period. Johnson behind the net, leads the rush back the other way. Johnson evades a man. That was Wilbur. Got it up to Emerson. Emerson tried to get it over the line. It was knocked away. Wilbur knocks it back down. Skates back the other way. Pass up on his wing to Polacek, who knocks it in. Johnson plays it along now. Got it up to Emerson. Emerson for Huffnagel. Huffnagel on the right wing. And over the line. Tried to get it to Davies. Threw a couple defenders. Still loose in the slot for the moment. Knocked away by the Blue Devils, and Leonard skates back. Sean Leonard. Pass up now to Wilbur, who's knocked down by Rutkowski. Who else? Pass up back down to Huffnagel. Huffnagel had it knocked away from him. Got it right back. Still at that blue line. Just camping right there. Blue Devils come up with it. Emerson comes in, lays a hit. Huffnagel tries to get it free once again for Davies. It's lofted back out to center ice as Brunn has it. Knocks it down. Sends it back behind his own net. Federer is going to be the first one there. Chips it along the boards up to Davies. Davies across center ice. Got it back to Federer, leaving the rush once again. Federer tried to drag a man with him. Still got the puck. Federer behind the net. Stops and starts. Sends it back behind Huffnagel. Tried to clear it in front, and it hit a skate and took a dangerous bounce, but Bogart was able to cover up. Sean Federer looks really good.
And it's good to see Sean Federer back on that blue line, coming in with a whole lot of speed. Great puck possession. That's what you'd like to see. He's one of you can make the argument that he's maybe one of, if not the best defenseman on this team. I think it's a fair argument to say, but he's certainly one of the better defenders, and it's good to see that he's at full health, and when he's at full health, he can be quite an asset to this Lakers team.
Face off won by the Lakers. They hold it in. Thought they'd have a chance for a moment, but Fredonia's able to corral the puck. That was Kassel. Get it back out to center ice. Haynes knocks it in behind Zawadzki. Kassel's going to come up with it up to Waterstreet. Waterstreet to Sullivan. Is a bit of a collision there. Waterstreet's going to send it into the Fredonia end as Haynes back up now to Gerhardsen. Gerhardsen is hit from behind by Sullivan. Goes behind Zawadzki. Met at the wall is MacMillan. And the Blue Devils come up with it to get it back to the point, as Ross is just barely able to hold that puck in with a backhand pass down low. Got it back to Rivera. Along now is Haynes. Haynes tried to get it back to the point. Leonard's able to hold it in. Goes back behind the net. MacMillan plays it. He's taken to the wall. Still being battled for. Regaseo had it free for the moment. And now here's Sullivan again. Sullivan off the glass to Waterstreet. Waterstreet is able to bank it into the Fredonia end. And he was not across center ice. And this is going to be an icing. 8 to go here in the third. Lakers lead 3-2.
And so with 8:09 left to go here in this game, Lakers up by one, like you said, off the much-needed goal here from McElotti here in the third. So now they find themselves up to one. They've come all back all the way down to nothing, and still a lot of time for Fredonia to get back in this one. But Oswego right now controlling the pace of play, time on possession too as well. We talk about a lot, or Coach Libby talked about how Fredonia likes to be patient. Well, patience has to somehow come out the window soon, because Fredonia's going to need to get a goal here.
Face off to the left of Zawadzki. One of the Lakers knocked back out to center ice. Galati gets it in deep to the Fredonia, and Bogart leaves it for Carlson. Carlson in the far corner. Back out to center ice. Barton tried to knock it down. And over the line now are the Blue Devils. There's Morgan. As the Lakers come up with it again, Galati tried to get it out and was able to do that just to center ice. Johnson fires it into the Blue Devil end. Carlson in the far corner of his own end as Hurley right on him sends it back behind his net for Jamie Young. Young felt the forecheck from Galati, sent it along to Morgan, held in by Johnson once again. Young can't knock it down. Off in the far corner, Hurley comes up with it. He's taken to the boards by Carlson. Barton behind the net. Barton sets up. Barton looking for a play. Try to get it in front. Galati with the backhand. They score! Point number 100 for Matt Galati. He's tacked on the last two as the Lakers now lead 4-2.
And what a way to get your 100th point right there, as he gets a goal right there to put the Lakers up 4-2. Matt Galati now, along with Alex Bodden and Sean Holzschroff, enters the 100-point club officially. And another much-needed goal, as now it's a big-time lead, down 2-0. Lakers score 4 unanswered goals here, 7:23 left to go, and now Fredonia is going to need to dig deep and act quick here soon to get this game tied back up.
Well, that they are. The Blue Devils won the faceoff, but it's held in by the Lakers at the point. Federer with a long shot, couldn't get it through. Back start, McAvoy. McAvoy in over the line is taken down, and we're going to get a penalty here against Chris Brunn. Brunn takes McAvoy to the boards hard, and we're going to get the whistle with 7 to go. It's going to be a trip against Chris Brunn.
And
so this is a good chance for Fredonia to answer.
This is a big-time chance right here. 7 minutes left to go still. Again, a lot of time to put 2 goals on. We've seen the Lakers score 2 goals within a minute. So we've just seen it alone how quick two goals can be scored. Now a power play opportunity for, again, a Blue Devil power play team that's
top five in the country has not been successful at all tonight.
0-3 tonight.
0-3 tonight. They're going to need to get this one. They're going to have a timeout on this one, as they're going to really need to score here to get back in this one, because there's 2 minutes left after this power play. If they don't score, it'll be 5 minutes left in the game, and then a two-goal comeback puts it a little bit more difficult with the time left on the clock.
Agreed. So we got the timeout and the pause right here. So Brun's in the box for 2 minutes. Matt Galati's put up his 100th point, we think. We're pretty sure.
We're 99.9% confident that was Matt Galati.
On the first goal. The first goal is the one in question.
Because Christopher Brun is not a forward, and he...
Well, yes.
Not
but
the
kind of Sean Federer, and Federer led that rush.
Yes, but it was right out in front of the net. And
you also saw Galati, right? It was
I saw Galati.
Okay.
Brun would never get towards the net like that.
Yeah.
So that is, without a doubt, Galati. They probably saw the four.
Yeah.
And... saw,
just went with it.
And went with it, but again, point 100, so that's a big congratulations there to
the third Laker this year.
And what a way to do it with two goals, too.
And Kenny Neal at least has 1 point tonight.
At least we don't have stats with us, but one, maybe 2 points.
He has a goal, I know that for a fact. I don't know if he got an assist on like the first goal or anything.
So 91 or 92 points.
Yeah. So he'll get there this season.
Good to see, but now this PK unit for Oswego, again, a penalty kill here, and a Fredonia comeback becomes just much and much more of an uphill climb.
That it does. This penalty kill brought to you by Seas Farm Market and Beverage Center. Held in off the point. Gerhardsen with a shot. Got through. Button tried to clear it. It's not out. Held in by Ortiz. Back behind the net. And this is going to be another penalty against the Lakers. It's going to be in Joey Rutkowski. So this is a glorious chance for the Blue Devils to answer. And it's going to be 2 minutes, I believe, interference. So a 5-on-3, we've seen the Lakers kill these before.
Two against Potsdam, but this is a different offense, and this is a different power play team. And a 5-on-3 chance for this particular power play unit is concerning. And Fredonia's got to score here. They have to score here. You don't get much a better chance to get back in this one than a 5-on-3, and a clear right away off the faceoff.
Yeah, it's 2 minutes for slashing against Joey Rutkowski. About a minute 40 to go on this 5-on-3, a long one. Gerhardsen leads the rush the other way. The penalty killers are Barton, Regaseo, and Hurley. Two forwards, interesting choice. I think we've seen this before, though. Blue Devils hold the puck in. It's being battled for along the near side wall. Barton got knocked down right inside the blue line. Lakers try to clear, and they don't. It's held in by Ortiz. Ortiz across to Gerhardsen. Gerhardsen back down low. Hits a skate, goes off into the corner. Morgan comes up with it. Back to the Mike Gerhardsen again. Gerhardsen across to Ortiz with a one-timer. Zalewski stopped that one. Along the far wall, coming up with it now is Polacek. Goes back to the point, Ortiz to Gerhardsen. Gerhardsen to Ortiz in the high slot with a shot, didn't get through. Knocked away by the Lakers. Regaseo tried to backhand. Barton tried to help him. Hurley, he's got it. He can't clear it. Held him by the Devils. Now Hurley with a second effort. Able to send the puck back down the ice. 45 seconds to go in the 5-on-3. And it's stolen by Johnson. Johnson with a soft shot stopped by Eric Bogart. You don't see 5-on-3 chances too much.
No, 5-on-3 shorthanded chances?
Yeah.
Not a lot right there.
As
they were coming off the change, and Johnson was able to just pick that puck up and from the neutral zone and fire it right away. So 40 seconds left from a 5-on-3, and that was a big kill right there from Hurley. It looked like that puck was still going to stay, but he then leaps out, uses the stick to just poke it up and out of the way. So a big play right there by Mitchell Hurley on the penalty kill.
So Fredonia has to win the defensive zone faceoff, and they do. Still up 5-on-3. Penalty kill-wise, Lakers lead this one 4-2 in a game. Castell, back the other way. Stick candles in over the blue line. Takes it down low. Pulls up in the far corner. Knocked up the puck by Federer. Neal comes up with it now. He's taking it up on the right wing. Neal gets in over the line. Sends it down deep. 15 to go in the 5-on-3. 30 to go in the second penalty to Rutkowski. 5 to go in the game. Back out to center ice, and Hurley, he tries to backhand it out in. It's knocked down at center ice once again. As Chris Burns going to skate back on the ice now. So the first penalty is killed off. 15 seconds to go in the second one. This penalty kill also brought to you by Seas Farm Market and Beverage Center. Gerhardsen holds it in. Here's Haynes again. Back to Gerhardsen. Gerhardsen doesn't shoot. Now he shoots. They hit a man in front. And Hurley is going to finish the job. Send him back on the ice. The Lakers kill a minute 45 of a 5-on-3. There's under 5 minutes to go here in the third period. Lakers up two goals. Back skates Gerhardsen with a pass. He turns it over. And Brun immediately turned it over. Ortiz shoots it with a shot. That was Rivera, excuse me. Might have hit the post. Definitely hit Zawatsky. Rivera couldn't play it behind the net. Emerson has it along the far or the near wall.
as the Lakers able to clear. Davies gets hit from behind, not able to clear it. It's knocked down by Regaseo. One of the net, Regaseo tied up his man Rivera. Goes off into the near wall once again. And there's going to be another penalty against the Lakers again, I would assume. It's going to be a cross-check.
Cross-check or boarding on that
one? It might have been a boarding. I know the cross-check sign is a just cross-check.
It looked like it was a boarding call there on Ragusa. So just after they kill a huge 5-on-3, which was a great penalty kill, great display of PK, they're back on it again. And this is kind of, I have to say, this is Fredonia's last chance. If they don't score here on this power play,
we saw the Lakers score 2 goals in a minute, so...
I mean, hold my breath. I guess anything can happen, but they need to score. This is absolutely the time they need to score.
Off the face-off, the Lakers clear it back down the ice immediately. Bogart's going to leave it behind the net for Casal. So Regaseo's in the box for 2 minutes. Lakers penalty kill 5-for-5 tonight. Penalty kill once again brought to you by C's Farm Market and Beverage Center. Fly ball into the Laker end. Knocked down behind the net, and then they're going to get a whistle.
As they're going to call that one offside.
Are they?
They're bringing this back.
Yeah,
they're bringing this puck
back.
They're
bringing it back to...
I think...
it's going to be right outside the Fredonia line. Offsides happen... they bring the faceoff wherever the offside occurs.
Yeah,
the pass was lofted in from that spot, so they're going to play it from right outside the Fredonia blue line.
My bad. My apologies there.
Still an offside either way, so... Fredonia wins the faceoff. Here's Ortiz. Minute 30 to go in the power play, 3:40 to go in the third. Lakers up 2. In behind the defense is Wilbur in the far corner. Wilbur, met there by Herlihy. Along back behind now. Polacek clears it back to the point for Ortiz. Ortiz takes it down low along the far wall. Pulls up. Gets Chris run off of him back to the point. Wilbur with a slap shot. Went wide of the net. Held in by Casale. Casale tried to take it down low. Herlihy knocked it away. Herlihy comes up with it. Herlihy. Across now to Barton. Barton's along the right wing. I don't think the Lakers are going to try for anything here. Barton's in over the line, sends it behind the net. Herlihy's going to be the first one there. As crowd's reacting to something, Herlihy gets pinned against the glass hard. Still no call there. That one behind the defense is Dunn. Dunn skates in with a shot. Zawatsky makes the stop. Rebound corralled by Steven Johnson. Back out to center ice. Herlihy stuck into Jamie Young and in skates Davies. And along with the shot, Bogart knocks it down, knocks the rebound away as Davies took out Bogart in front of the net, back behind the net now. 30 seconds to go in the power play. This game is getting really chippy.
Real fast, real quick. A lot of hits along the boards, and Oswego looking for a call on Fredonia. They didn't get it, and they are quite upset. They were quite upset on the bench.
Emerson, behind the net. Emerson gets by a check nicely. He's in the far corner. Lakers still killing a penalty here. Doesn't look like it. Emerson has it tied up in the far corner of the Fredonia, and Doug Freed to Davies. Back to the point. He's just going to send it back down the ice. And... basically, that's going to do it for the Fredonia power play. Zawatsky's going to send a pass all the way back up ice to Steven Johnson. He's going to fire it into the Fredonia end. Rolls to Bogart. Left it there. Fredonia defense takes over. Here's Sean Leonard. Skates it out himself. 2 to go here in the third period. Lakers lead by 2. Brunn has to fight off McAvoy. Johnson tries to dig it away from Rivera now in the near corner of the Laker end. The Lakers do dig it free. Get it back out to center ice. This one is not going to be an icing. It's waved off. Doesn't roll far enough. Leonard has to chip it away from Botten. McAvoy. Back out to center ice. Regaseo is going to knock it down. Botten couldn't control that pass. Leonard takes over. Back in his own end is Max Ruff. Minute and a half to go. Ruff banks it on in. Brunn knocks it down. He's going to fire it back out to center ice. Ross comes up with it. Ross with Neal right on his back. He's able to get outside the Oswego blue line. Now it's still just being battled for. Bogart's still in the net. You would think they'd pull him soon. Casale fires it deep into the Laker end, and Bogart shows no signs of moving. Here's Chris Brunn. Up now to Botten. Botten back behind his own net. As it's now up to Holshoff. Holshoff clears the zone. It's out to center ice. Here's Neal. Neal tried to chip it across to Botten. Bogart directs it away. Botten has it in the near corner. Botten stick handles away. He's taken to the boards, and the Blue Devils come back. Polacek up to Morgan. Morgan falls. Can't control the pass. Bogart's going to go to the net. We're going to get a penalty here against the Lakers, I believe.
Or
maybe not. Well, I need to stop guessing.
Well, like you said, they're waiting. Fredonia didn't have possession of the puck for a while.
Against the Blue Devils.
On
Sam Wilbur, so that's going to do it for this game.
Pretty much, and they were waiting a while to pull.
And then when they did, they took a penalty.
Exactly, and they didn't have possession of the puck, as the Lakers were able to control.
puck possession late in those final 2 minutes. And like you said, just as Bogar was heading to the net, Fredonia commits a penalty, and now they're going to have to find a way to score shorthanded twice within 40 seconds.
The faceoff is won by the Lakers to the right of Bogart. Lakers are just content tying it up. Galati's battling for it down low. Got it free to Neal. Neal across, got it to try to get it to hole shot. Backstart Schaus. The Lakers, Blue Devils have a 2-1-1. Schaus with Dunn. Schaus skates in with a shot. Zawadzki makes the stop. It goes up and over the net. Neal tries to knock it down. Johnson digs it free. He's behind his own net. The Blue Devil net is empty. Hole shot came clear. Johnson digs it free. Got it to Neal. Neal is checked. Blue Devils have it behind the net. Dug free for the moment. Blue Devils still have it. Tried to clear it back to the point, and it will come back out to center ice. Dunn comes up with it. Pass across ice now. Spagnardi's just going to fire it in, and that's going to do it here from Steel Hall Arena as the Lakers, down 2-0, storm back, score 4 goals in a row. 2 at the end of the second period, 2 in the third, and they seal this 4-2 victory.
And once again, the undefeated season continues. The Lakers now 10-0 on the season. And again, the perfect undefeated season continues on. And this was quite a battle for the Lakers tonight. This is a very much improved Blue Devil team. And I would be stunned if Fredonia did not make the SUNYAC playoffs, because this is a very good team.
They're a
very good team that gave Oswego a run for their money, and up 2-0. But the Lakers, they've been down before, and they did it again here tonight, scoring 4 unanswered goals, rallying back behind down 2-0. Second comeback we've seen just this semester alone, and a big win for Oswego as they continue to be a theme. When they are met with adversity, they respond. And that is an encouraging sign to see. They've done it twice already in this fall semester. And now they're 10-0 going into another big contest tomorrow night against Buffalo State. Another good team who's right there, right behind the Lakers in the SUNYAC standing. So they'll celebrate this one tonight, but then they've got to gear up for another big SUNYAC contest tomorrow in Buffalo.
Well, that they will. Your final score here from Steel Hall, the Oswego State Lakers 4, the Fredonia Blue Devils 2. As we have a lot more coming up on the post-game show, Laker Roundup, as well as we'll have Coach Sigby for Coach's Corner. So until then, we will take this quick break and send it back to Sam Watkins and the rest of the guys in the studio for Laker Roundup. You've been listening to Laker Hockey here on WNYO 88.9 FM, Laker Radio, your way.
Yo, this is Sam Watkins, wide receiver for the Buffalo Bills, and you're listening to WNYO 88.9 FM, Oswego, New York. Go Bills!